once again, God have allowed us to come out to do a feeding, this Labor Day feeding. Once again, was a success. The rain came, and yet we still was able to serve many that came down. Very special guests that came down. I thank God just for using me. It's just a blessing. It's just a blessing to be a blessing. And I know God did not bless me for me, but He blessed me to be a blessing and to give to others. And I just, once again, I'm full of joy. I'm full of joy knowing that God have used me in a way that it's so hard to explain. It's so hard to explain. Like I said before, to be used by God is like the greatest thing in the world. Please feel free and get as many souls as you need. Amen. If you know anyone that needs some clothes, be a good neighbor to help them out as well. Amen. Just the greatest thing in the world, you know. Once again, I think about the days I slept out in this park. I think about the days just needing a meal, a bite to eat. You know, I remember those days. But right now, you know, I can't even remember the last time I had to even worry about what I was going to eat, what I was going to drink, where I'm going to lay my head. Because just obeying God's word, obeying God Himself, He have blessed me to have a roof over my head, to have clothes on my body. I'm soaking wet right now and I'm laughing. The rain came, and just to see the volunteers standing at their posts, not moving, being dedicated to God, to God's people, to just give it back, was just a blessing along itself.
Worship God today. We thank you. We're going to also have a welcome for Minister Armstrong also.
God for this day. It rained today, but it's a blessed day, and we thank God we were able to come out. We were chosen to come out by God, so we continue to serve. Rain, sleet, snow, or hail, even in the hot sun, we come out because it's all about God's business. And we thank God for allowing us to be the chosen one. Many are chosen, a few are called. So we thank you. We thank God for this day. How you doing?
I thank God.
You see, business which belongs to God, kingdom business which belongs to God, it shall continue. We thank God for the mighty men walking with Christ's ministry. We thank God. We thank God for all the volunteers. We thank God for the people that came and they just fellowship with us. We thank God for a peaceful day. We thank God for His rain. And that's it. And I'm digging that hope. To understand all I feel deeper still, and always will. All this love is for you.
Every melody I feel are only for you and your
I apologize. I don't have time.
I'm definitely step by His grace. Okay. I'm gonna give you a card because I'm gonna card
him. Okay. How you doing?
I know. Be blessed.
Oh.
Yeah, this is a beautiful thing that Brother Ron and our brother Reverend Poland doing for the community and everything. They used to doing this and everything. It's beautiful, but they can come out and give away clothes and everything. The community deserves that, and they're deserving people that deserve the respect that they have for doing it for us. And we respect them for that. And I thank God for it.
My name is Jerry Gibson, and I'm with Brother Polo. And I love what Brother Polo do, and I love what he stands for. His brother not only speaks the walk, and walks the walk, he walks and talks the talk. He does what is in his heart. And I'm just glad to be a part of this. You know, it gives me an opportunity to not only give back, but to understand how God is using us to give back to people. And I'm just glad to be a part of it. I'm loving what's going on. It's a beautiful thing. And I'm just grateful to be here and grateful to be able to give of myself. I think that's the most important thing that we as people either do or don't do. And when you give of yourself, I think that's when God really gets into your life. So I'm just glad to be here. Thank you.
We thank you, Lord God. I just want to say thank you, Lord God, for giving me an opportunity, Lord God, to come before your throne of grace, Lord God, interceding for your people, Lord God. We bless your name. Hallelujah. You said enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. Hallelujah. I praise you, Lord God, because not only are you God, but you are my Father. We bless your name. You are our helper, Lord God. We bless your name. You are our creator, Lord God. We bless you. You are our redeemer. We thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We thank you, God, for going before us, God, making every crook place straight and every rough place smooth. We bless your name today, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you chose us, Lord God, that you plucked us out of the hand of the enemy, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for an opportunity to serve you, an opportunity to live for you, Lord God. We bless your name. We thank you for your son, Jesus, Lord God. We thank you for the redemptive work of the cross, Lord God. We thank you for the blood, Lord God. Hallelujah, that makes us whole, Lord God, that heals us, that delivers us. We bless your name today. We thank you, Lord God. Look upon everyone, Lord God, under the sound of my voice, Lord God. Send your anointing, Lord God, to destroy every yoke, Lord God, to lift every burden. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, do a new thing in us, Lord God. Take us to higher heights, Lord God, and deeper depths in you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for creating in us a clean heart, oh God, and renewing a right spirit within us, Lord God. We bless your name. We thank you, Lord God, that our soul thirsts for you, Lord God. We thank you that we hunger for you, Lord God. We pray right now, Lord God, that you will remove everything from us, Lord God, that it's not pleasing to you, Lord God. We bind every addiction in our lives, Lord God. We bind a lying tongue, Lord God. We bind a rebellious spirit, huh? We bind a disobedient spirit, huh? We bind a gossiping spirit, huh? Everything, Lord God, that would displease you, Lord God. We pray right now, Lord God, for the spirit of truth to rest upon our lives, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you for your sanctifying power, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you're causing us to be stabilized in you, Lord. Glory to your name, Lord God. We bless your name, Lord God. Saturate this place, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Loose the spirit of healing in this place, Lord God. A spirit of deliverance in this place, Lord God. Glory to your name, Lord God. You said no man can come to you, Lord God, unless you draw. Draw to you, Lord God. You know what it takes to draw.
Hey, the event y'all throwing right now is wonderful for the community and for the people. More people need to get together and do this, because this community needs it. I mean, it really does. Property is going down. We have empty houses everywhere. We need to fill these houses. The government and all the politicians need to come over here and see this, man, because this community is falling with drugs and drinking. So y'all need to get together and come over here. Over here, right across the street from the train station.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
The scripture be coming from the book of Psalms 150. first through the sixth verse. And it reads, praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him in the mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sounds of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery of harp. Praise him with the timbrels and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon the loud cymbal. Praise him upon the high-sounding cymbal. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Everything.
For this blessing, for the food, clothes, and the people. Amen.
We're going to have a testimony from our dear sister Yvette. We're going to have a testimony. Somebody bless the Lord while she's coming.
Amen. Okay. Hi.
Bless you, everyone. Thank you so much for the opportunity to share my testimony. My name is Yvette Pegues, and that's my shy son, Elijah Pegues. And I also have an older son, Isaiah Pegues. And I'd love to share my testimony. Thank you, Napoleon, for the opportunity. And I just want to share with everyone the blessing that I celebrate with you, the opportunity to sit in this wheelchair that I now claim is my cross. I sit in the cross, and I wanted to share with each and every one of you that for the past 2 years, I had the opportunity to share with a lot of people my testimony. But 2 years ago, I actually worked in a business in corporate America, actually. And unbeknownst to me, obviously God knew, I had a brain condition that took me to the emergency room, and they told me that I had a condition in my brain that put me in a very difficult position and my family in a very difficult position where I would need to have brain surgery. So of course, that wasn't my plan for myself. Coming out of college, I was actually an engineer. So my plan for myself was to be a CEO of a big company and have a life for my family that would put us in a position that was not sitting down but standing up. So we went through a lot of different doctors, and they told us, oh, it's no problem, it's easy. We're gonna go in, we're gonna look at your brain, and we're gonna fix it. So we made plans to go in, have our brain surgery, and walk out. But God had different plans. I didn't walk out. I sat down, and I'm still sitting, and it's 2 years later. So for the first year, I laid on my back, and I cried. And my babies were 3 and 5, and my oldest child came home and said, Mommy, are you gonna die? And I said, God, no, I'm not gonna die. And I know that you use sand, you spit on it, and you put it over the eyes of the blind man, and he saw. So I know that you can use me too. And he can use each and every one of you. So I just wanna tell you, each and every one of you, that if he can use me sitting down, he can use you standing up. I also want to tell you that I was moving too fast when I was standing up for God to use me. He had to sit me down. Because since I've been sitting down, I want to tell you I've done so much more ministry on my back and sitting down than I ever did standing up.
Amen.
And when I opened my eyes and told my baby, no, I'm not going to die, I have been ministering to people in wheelchairs. I've been ministering to people who have disabilities that you can't see. It's obvious when you look at me that I have a disability, but my purpose in life is to help people with disabilities that you can't see. And those are the ones that are so important to me. Jeremiah 29, if you have your Bibles, please turn to it. I want you to understand that God says, I know the plans that I have for you, plans to prosper you, and not to harm you, but to give you hope for a future. And that's the plans that I am following in my life for each and every one of you. The other thing that I want you to understand that's so important to me and that got me out of my bed and made me very purposeful in my life is 1 Kings 19. What happened to Elijah, a strong warrior who fought so hard, and then Jezebel and Ahab said, I'm going to kill you. Elijah, a strong soldier of God, now hears from a woman who says she's going to kill him, runs to the mountain and hides. Why? Because even the strong in spirit has their breaking point. I was at my breaking point. My husband now has to raise two young men and his wife. He had to bathe me. He had to take care of me. He had to do everything that ahead is already destined and plans to be done according to the word of God. But I cried because now my husband has to do everything for me. But let me tell you what God told Elijah. First, he told him to get up and eat. He put food next to his head. So today, you're going to be fed. You're going to be fed by these strong men. They're going to make sure that you eat. So if you're tired, think about Elijah. He was tired too.
Lord, I think this is my 4th or 5th year that I've been with you. I love the experience. It's real fun and spirit fun. That's what I like about it. I'm glad I'm a part of this ministry, you know, because a lot of work to be done. So the feeding, everything was real. And I wouldn't miss it for nothing in the world that time that, you know, they have. I try to make my best to get out of here. You know, it was excellent.
Shake that person hand next to you and say, you looking mighty good today. And God ain't through with you. As I look out, I see all the beautiful faces. And I see the volunteers and the people who made this possible. And I'm just truly grateful to just be a part of something that's just bigger than me. I'm not going to hold you long, but anyway, one of the things that I wanted to read comes out of Matthew. And it's Matthew 5 and 6. And it says, blessed are they which are hungry, or blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. And we're going to skip down to the 14th verse. And it says, you are the light of the world. I'm sorry, 13. You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under the foot of men. The 14th verse says, you are the light of the world. A city that sits on the hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under the bushel, but on a candlestick. And it gives light unto all who are in the house. And I want to say to all of you, you are candles in the light of the world. The only difference is, where is your light? Are you hiding your light? Or is it bright so that men can see? As stated before, even though she's had afflictions, even though things have happened in her life, she's determined to let her light shine. That's the only difference between her and you. Are you letting your light shine? Does it require work? Of course it does. Anything worthwhile you have to work for. Are you going to have to be determined? Yeah, because there are going to be things that's going to come your way that say you can't do it. You ain't good enough. You're too short. You ain't light enough. Your smile ain't pretty enough. But what are you going to do about it? See, there's only one thing, only one enemy that you battle, and that enemy is yourself. But once you get past of what you can and cannot do, or all the naysayers, I mean, the rest is up to you. So I challenge each and every one of you from this day forward to determine what is your life. I mean, you may be an engineer, you may be a doctor. Hey, just because you may not have a place to go right now, that doesn't mean a thing. There have been plenty of people. I mean, if you read the Bible, you will see God has made examples of drunks, whores, prostitutes, thieves, murderers. You read the Bible, it's all in there. So whatever your shortcoming may be, don't look at your shortcoming, look at what God can do for you. Because he don't have no respect to person. What he'll do for me, he'll do for you too. And the thing about it is, he wait. Why do we have God sitting on the bench in our game of life? God is sitting on the bench asking to be put in the game, and you down by 40, and he can score one touchdown or whatever you equate it to and cause you to win the game. It's up to you. Do you want to win or not? Like I say, it's up to you. I'm not going to hold you long, but I just want to say you are the salt of the world. Let your light shine. From this point forward, let your light shine. Do something for somebody. When you leave here, don't just be that person that occupied a space. Because we got enough of those that's already out in the cemetery. The cemetery is the most richest place in the world. You know why? Because all those ideas and resources are dead. Yeah. As long as you got life, you got something to be saved. Right. As long as you got life, you got work to do. And I challenge each and every one of you to do your job. Like I say, you can't be Bro Polo. He done claim that. You can't be this sister over here. She's got that corner, that market already cornered. Whatever it is that you do, God gave it to you, and he's already preordained your journey. So I challenge each and every one of you that whatever it is that you're supposed to be doing, be about the business of doing whatever it is that you got to do. Because somebody is sitting somewhere for you to bless.
What it do, EB Poy, shout it in representative, man, live from Cabin Street. Grind Media, once again in the streets, man, and on some positive man, feed the homies, man. We live on Ashley Street, man. You see how these folks, they showing these folks love out here, man. And I salute you, man. That's how you bless it come back. Grind Media, man, Street Zone, I'm f***ing with y'all guys, man. You hear me? Takeover, man. Now or never, crunch time.
How important do it feel to be out here and feeding the homeless and giving back?
You know what I mean? I be out here every day with these folks, man. So I really see really impact these folks, you know what I mean? Really helping these folks, man, you know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Doing stuff like that, it's gonna always come back to you. I salute y'all on.
Before, it's a privilege too, okay? Because God is, and you've heard it already this morning, God is no respecter of persons.
Amen.
He does not see the outside, he sees the inside. It doesn't matter if we're poor, rich, crippled, or handicapped in some way, or we have all our gifts. The thing is that God has given us a spiritual gift, and that is more important. And what I wanted to say was, it actually, along with what my sister just said in terms of your thoughts, I remember there's a phrase that I learned, and it merely makes sense, and that is, your thoughts become your actions. Actions create your habits. Habits form your character, and character is your destiny. The character you have now is either a character that's in the world or a character that's in Christ. And that is your destiny, and eternity makes a difference as to where that character is. And that's why I want to tell you that the important thing here today is not just the food. The food is great, and it comes from God. It doesn't come from us. Okay, God is leading people to do certain things as he leads you and to use your gift. And I like my brother said, I hope some of you one day will be with us and doing the same kind of thing, or just on your own. Anyways, I want to bring to you a little bit of the Word of God, because I know that if anything, I may say something, you'll forget it. But if anything, God's Word never returns void. And he has stated that in his Word, and I know that's his Word, and he promises to keep his Word, and he will. Amen. Thank you. Nice effect. Okay. The parable of the rich fool is something I want to bring out to you, because it's so important that we understand where we are in life and what we really need, okay? I had a great job for 23 years. It was going good. I was promoted. I got very well in my job. And then one day, even after I was promoted 3 weeks before, I get laid off. And after I got laid off, I was a little too old for most people to even want me. Okay? I did find a few jobs. I found a few jobs, but nothing ever came in hand of it. I always ended up losing it with year after or whatever. And I've been laid off more years since 2001 than working, okay? So the thing is though, it took that. Not the good days.
Once again, I thank my brother AJ for coming out, taking the pictures, doing the video. My brother, you do a wonderful job, man. And I pray to God others use you and their events as well. I love you and may God bless.
Hey, she needs some shoes, man.